This video will show you how to use the material-to-material calculator in Thermo-Calc to calculate the transition of an iron-chromium-nickel alloy from one composition to another. The goal of this calculation is to explore whether deleterious phases might form in a graded transition joint between a martensitic stainless steel and a highly alloyed austenitic stainless steel. The calculation uses a demo database and only three elements, so it can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc 2022A or newer, including those who are using the free educational package. The calculation is based on example T14 of the examples included in your software. In this video, I will show you how to set up the example yourself. To begin, open Thermo-Calc in the graphical mode. Click on the Material to Material template from the home screen of the software. This will load all the nodes we need for this type of calculation. From the Database drop-down menu, select the FE Demo Database. Next, select the elements iron, chromium, and nickel. Next, we will set the composition of one of the materials. Iron will be dependent, so we'll let that set automatically. Chromium will be 17, and nickel will be 2, which automatically sets iron to 81 mass percent. This is a simplified chemistry for a martensitic stainless steel. Next, select the Material to Material Calculator node, which is where we will configure our calculation. Change the temperature unit to Celsius and set the temperature to 650 degrees. This could represent a heat treatment or operating temperature. We will accept the default values for all of the other settings. Notice that the composition for our first material propagated from the system definer. For the second material, set the chromium content to 19 and the nickel content to 35. The program will calculate the transition of the alloy from the initial composition to the second composition. Notice that you can also change the names of each of the materials. For example, we can name the first material martensitic stainless steel and the second material, alloy 800. Under calculation type, select one axis. Set the quantity to mass fraction of alloy 800, which is the name we gave to the second material. We will accept the default values of a minimum of 0, a maximum of 1, and a step division of 50. Our calculation is now set, so click Perform Tree at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, your plot will appear in the results pane. The default plot shows the volume fraction of all phases as a function of the mass fraction of the second material, which in this case is alloy 800. We can see that the martensitic stainless steel composition is BCC at this temperature, and the highly alloyed stainless steel is FCC. Neither material is expected to form any deleterious phase on its own at 650 degrees Celsius. However, mixtures of these two materials, which could arise from a graded transition joint, weld, or potentially a diffusion couple, show some stability for the deleterious sigma phase at this temperature. Now you can try to make small adjustments to the initial chemistries to reduce the potential for the sigma phase to form. We hope you find this example useful. We are constantly working to create new videos, so if there are any videos you would like us to make, please leave a comment below the video. We have many other videos available on our website in the video tutorials section.